The shrinking of the organs, and then sort of in the refeeding phase, the regrowing is kind of something I wanted to talk to you about as well. This rejuvenation process, because you've obviously shown this now in several different studies, both with fasting and fasting-mimicking diet in animals, where they lose a significant amount of their different organs, right? And I think that you, maybe you want to talk about this.
So in mice, for example, if you look at the weight of most organs, and this is, of course, was known for calorie restriction long term, but with fasting and fasting-mimicking diet, this happens much more rapidly. So the organs will be smaller, and at the end of the days of fasting-mimicking diet, and then you refeed, and of course they go back to the normal level, right? So there's really there is this shrinking and re-expanding effect. Now, we don't know how much of it is cells becoming smaller versus cells being killed, but clearly there is killing of cells.
Yeah.
And something, of course, we are also very interested in is their preferential killing of the damaged cells. And we've started to show that in our multiple sclerosis mouse model, and also the human study, there was evidence that the white blood cell level temporarily was reduced during the at the end of the fasting cycles, and then went back to normal. So yeah, so we suspect that there are these fasting dependent depletion of both intracellular components, autophagy, and cellular components, and then we've shown the stem cell to be activated, and then the stem cell during the refeeding part, and that's another very important point is that differentiates it to most of other interventions, right? All of a sudden, even the intermittent fasting, because you don't have enough time. If you do like even one day, it barely even gets you into the ketogenic mode, right? And of course, if you didn't eat for one day, you wouldn't want to break down too many of the components. That's probably having all the glycogen and having all the digestion. It takes 30 hours to complete the food digestion, right? From the time you eat to the time that all the calories have been taken up, it takes probably over a day. So so that's a very important distinction between the prolonged fasting and everything else, including calorie restriction, which does not have the refeeding moment, right? So if the rebuilding happens during refeeding and you never have it, then of course you're missing out the reconstruction part, which is as important as the destruction part.